Well, it's been some time since Xiaomi launched the Mi A1. This is the phone, and this is their first phone that runs on Android One. That's Google's project that gives you stock Android experience and promises you regular updates. And it also happens to be Xiaomi's first phone with a dual camera setup in India. So two things that were really the key highlights of this phone. And this phone still runs on the Snapdragon 625 processor, the processor that Xiaomi really loves and that is there in most of the phones. And with a stock Android UI, the performance does, you know, become a little better because it doesn't really put all that strain with customization. Xiaomi has in fact just kept only three apps over here. And yes, like I said, the camera is USB. So how did the phone really fare in all these weeks that we have been using the phone? It's time to give you the full report card. Mi A1 comes with a design that is similar to other Xiaomi devices. They're slim, beautiful, easy to hold and operate. The ergonomically placed volume rocker, power buttons and fingerprint scanner keeps the design simple yet attractive, somewhat similar to the iPhone 7. For Xiaomi's followers, the Mi device is running on Android 7.1.2 and an Android Oreo update before the end of this year is a treat. The Mi A1 is powered by a 2GHz Qualcomm Snapdragon 625 octa-core processor coupled with 4GB of RAM. That makes this device one of the most powerful sub 15,000 rupees smartphone. The Moto G5 S Plus is one of the few affordable smartphones to use this chipset. LG Q6 is driven by an inferior Snapdragon 435 octa-core processor around the same price. The absence of bloatware reduces the load on the hardware, delivering a butterfly smooth experience. Apps open faster, switching between apps is smooth, and even with 8 to 10 apps running in the background, the smartphone was able to handle graphic-intensive games without any hiccups. The back did warm up a little during gaming, but the heat was evenly spread and no area felt particularly hot. The smartphone packs in a 3080 mAh battery, which is not much on paper but adequate enough to deliver a day's backup if you don't stress it too much. Internal storage is 64GB and one can add up to 128GB via micro SD card. It is more than enough for most tasks. Also, like the Pixel smartphones, you get unlimited cloud storage for high quality photos and videos. The Mi A1 has a pair of 12-megapixel sensors where one is a wide-angle lens and the other a telephoto. Both combine to shoot photos with DSLR-like bokeh effect, just like other premium devices. There is a portrait mode meant for shooting photos with blurred background. As a package, the phone clicks beautiful photos in the right lighting conditions. Nothing remarkable in the camera, but the output does justice to the dual camera system. You need steady hands to get blur-free shots using the optical zoom lens as there is no OIS on the camera. Shots in low light are noisy. The 5-megapixel front camera clicks clear and noise-free selfies.
Alright, time for the verdict now. The Xiaomi Mi A1. It's priced for 14,999 as you already know. And alright, just to sum it up, if you talk about the design, well, you really can't go wrong with this design, right? So this design works. It has worked for many other phones. It works for Xiaomi as well. The stock Android experience is good, man. It's flawless, smooth. The performance with the 625 is very reliable, like I said. So it's not a powerhouse, but it gives you a dependable performance. So I think that's also been taken care of. The next thing is, of course, is the camera and the portrait mode, the bokeh effect that it really offers. And I must say the results are pretty good, but the only condition is that you should be clicking those portrait shots in a good lighting condition, because under low light it tends to suffer, and as is the case with all the phones that are offering this feature. So besides that, yeah, the battery, of course, we expected more, but should just about last you the day, and I think the pricing is also pretty good. So yes, if you're considering buying a phone under 15,000 rupees, this is one of the good options that is out there, because if you use Xiaomi phones, then you would know, and if you haven't, But then, yeah, there's always the first time. So I think this phone really passes in what it offers.